The base iPad is one of the best bang for your buck computers Apple has to offer. And this year it got some really nice upgrades. So first up, the display got upgraded to support True Tone. Now, for those that aren't aware, what True Tone does is it measures the light temperature of the room and shifts the display so that the white balance is always kind of proper. It's a really nice feature that has been around in the iPad Pro, I believe, since the second generation iPad Pro. It also got an A13 chip. This is an upgrade from the A12 chip that the iPad got last year. It's a solid upgrade. It's a good upgrade. It's faster. There's not really too much to say about it. We already know what the A13 chip has to offer from previous devices. It's a fast chip. It's solid. It is a couple years old, but I think that's all a part of keeping this iPad's price at what it is. The feature I'm really excited about, though, is the camera upgrades, but specifically the front-facing camera has the ultra-wide lens, so that can enable center stage. Center stage is a feature that came to the iPad Pros earlier this year and then is coming to the iPad Mini and now this ninth generation iPad. It uses this ultra-wide lens to kind of crop in and basically frame you in a video call properly. And it's not just FaceTime, third-party apps can support this as well. I really like this feature, especially because I'm doing a lot of video calls right now. And before, I always had to jump on a couple of minutes ahead of time to make sure I was properly framed, because I'm a video guy, and if my frame was off, and it's looking up at me at a bad angle or something like that, that's just embarrassing. So with center stage, I don't really have to worry about it. I just let it do its thing and it automatically frames me. And what's cool is if somebody comes into the video call and joins in, it'll widen up and include them as well. But I think the most important point of this new generation of iPad is that it now has double the storage for the same price. So the 64 gig model is still $329. That's why I say it's the best bang for your buck for a computer Apple sells. You can walk into an Apple store and walk out with one of these. It's the best bang for your buck. There isn't really any new exclusive features or redesign or anything that special about this iPad. It's getting a lot of features from its siblings iPads. A lot of iPad Pro features have been trickling down the line and they are coming to this iPad now, like Center Stage and True Tone. But the fact that it can stay at that same price point, I think, is probably the most important thing for Apple, other than the fact shipping a good computer, shipping a good iPad. Hitting that same price point every year, I think, is a real key to Apple, because it hasn't changed in, I think, 4 years? That might be right, maybe a little shorter than that. 3 years, somewhere around there. But also, another really important point is this iPad right here, this ninth generation iPad, and this 2021 iPad Pro 12.9 inch have the same OS. They have the same access to the same features. So that means you can do multitasking, split view, the new Quick Note, keyboard shortcuts, all the stuff that you could do on the iPad Pro software-wise, you could do on this iPad. It can run all the same apps. Now, obviously, the iPad Pro is gonna run them faster. They're gonna run them better. It has more storage options and few more hardware-specific features. But I think that goes to show how versatile the iPad line is this iPad and this iPad, the price is very, very different between the two, but when it comes to, you know, running the same OS and having the same software features, they're the same. Now, I'm not gonna rehash everything that's in iPad OS 15. I just did a 45-minute video on it, so I will link to that in the description below. You can check it out if you're curious about what's in iPad OS 15. There is a lot of good stuff in there. My channel is sponsored by Paperlike. Paperlike is a textured screen protector. So when you're using the Apple Pencil and you're writing on the display, it feels like you're writing with pen and paper or pencil and paper and not plastic on glass. It's a much better feeling if you're drawing or writing things out with the Apple Pencil. It's honestly one of my favorite products. I highly recommend the Paperlike, and I will put my link in the description below. Now, one thing I want to mention is it's still using the first generation Apple Pencil and that first generation Smart Connector keyboard. This has been around for a while now, and I mean, it's nice. It's not a bad keyboard, and this isn't a bad Apple Pencil, but the improvements that their successors have made they're just so much better. I think it's time for Apple to start thinking about how they can incorporate the modern iPad accessories on this base iPad. I'm not even necessarily suggesting the Magic Keyboard, but there's also the Smart Folio Keyboard as well, which was just a better product because you could open it up. You didn't have to do the origami thing like with this one where you have to like unfold it and then fold it back and stuff like that. I really didn't care for that whole process. So I think it's time they start thinking about that. Also, the Apple Pencil, the second generation Apple Pencil, this one right here, is such an improvement over this first one, just because of how it connects, you know, using that flat edge and charging and magnetically connects. This one, you're still having to plug it in the Lightning port. And while, I mean, it works and that's fine, it's slightly a little frustrating. So in future iterations of this iPad, I would like to see Apple incorporate the modern iPad accessories. But at the end of the day, if you want an affordable laptop, if you want a laptop that's not going to cost you $1,000 or $2,000, this is a good setup right here with the Smart Connector and the Apple Pencil. That whole package right there, you can get for about $587 US. And again, this runs all the iPadOS features, runs modern iPad apps. Well, I don't have any issues. I have some creative apps on here. I tried them out, like LumaFusion and Ferrite, and they work just fine. But if you already have an iPad or another computer you primarily work for, there is another use case for this iPad. I did a video last year focused on the 8th generation version of it, but it's still completely relevant, and I will link to it in the description below, about talking how this base iPad can kind of complement an iPad Pro in your workflow, or maybe a MacBook Pro or iMac or something like that. I talked in that video about how you can turn this iPad into an automation server and do a lot of other stuff with it. I think it could be a really interesting secondary device, and at the price point, it doesn't cost a whole lot. So that's the 9th generation iPad. That's my thoughts on it. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments below. I'll answer to the best of my ability. Thank you all so much for watching, and have a great day.